I bought this surface at Hobby Lobby probably, oh gosh, months ago. And it all looked like this, okay? It had this color in the center, okay? But I switched it out a little bit and it's not gonna remain black. It's gonna be crackle finished. What I did was I prepared it just a little bit here. I prepared the surface with black fusion mineral paint. Coal black, it's called. Coal black. And then dried it completely. Then, on top of that, I put a layer of folk art crackle medium. Okay. Then, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take this big old honking brush here, and I am gonna put some fusion mineral paint in raw silk. This is the color, raw silk. What you wanna do is when you crackle finish, you wanna go over it thickly, and because it starts crackling like right away, I'm going to put this on good and thick. My first pass. And you'll see what I mean. It starts almost immediately crackling. You don't want to go over it a lot. But, I mean, you want to. And look at all that crackle. Isn't that gorgeous? I love the instantaneous gratification.
Dry it.
It has to be dried really, really well for what I'm going to do next. So let's just... All right. Okay, so for starters, I'm going to show you these beautiful spring peonies that we are going to put on here. Big focal point, besides the peonies, is going to be, are you ready? This gal right here. Isn't she beautiful? Oh my word, I'm so excited to get this on here. I'm so excited. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to peel this. This is a transfer, y'all. This is a transfer, right? She's going to take up most of the area here, as you can well see. So once I get her down, just peel the backing off very gently, okay? Okay. And I'm going to get her to go kind of more toward the bottom here. Yeah. Maybe I'll just do her in the middle. I'll just do it in the middle. Like that. I want to kind of get her centered here and just kind of press it lightly down so it starts its transferring. It's gonna be cute. All right, and so we're gonna take your little transfer tool and you're gonna give it the rub. You're just gonna give it the rub. I'm gonna go. You can see what I'm doing. It will start lightening as you're rubbing. You'll see where it's ready to be released, where it's ready to be pulled up. Like here it's a little bit darker, here it's lighter. All of the above. Look at that. Look at that gorgeous cow. Is that not amazing? Look at that. Cool. What I want to do with this one is I want to add some of the peonies and just the littler ones I want to put here and there. And she's going to have a little wreath of flowers in her hair. So just so you know. Aren't these gorgeous? I mean, seriously, y'all, these are pretty. I'm going to use these little ones here for the corners, kind of wrap around, you know, like that.
What you get.
All right. I'm going to put this just like I had it. Oh, that's going to be so pretty, right? Okay, go ahead. All right. Oh, pretty, pretty, pretty. So, okay, I'm going to rub that on. And I'll get it Okay, rub-a-dub-dub, here we go. Take two, three. Like I said, you want to make sure that the backside is clear when you pull it up. And if it's not, keep a rubbing. That suggestion. Okay, look at this, you guys. Isn't that pretty? Look at that. In a matter of minutes. Isn't it gorgeous? I'm loving it too.
Flowers.
But what I want to do before I do anything else is I want to show you the stencil. The stencil I'm going to use, it's wider than, the word is that I'm using tonight is bloom. Now this stencil comes with this and it comes with this beautiful lily. Okay, but I'm going to use the word bloom because this sweet little cow is going to be blooming with flowers in her hair. So I'm going to put the word bloom, stencil it on there. Pull this apart. All right, when you store your stencils, you want to make sure you keep this packaging and put it back in there because it's going to keep it nice for you. Here's the thing. When I use my Bling tool or any of that, I store it away immediately. I don't keep it out. I'm not as good with my paintbrushes as I am with those tools because, you know, they're a little more expensive. But, and look at it. It's shaped like a tag, right? It's shaped like a tag, but we are going to put it here. Now, here's the thing. It's a little longer. It's a little bit longer, but that is okay because what I'm going to do is I'm going to take and fix that once it is, once it's on. I want to make sure it's taped down in all the spots it needs to be taped down, and I'm going to just use this painter's tape, okay? So that it doesn't move. It doesn't have to be. I did. I'm going to put a little bit of this black fusion mineral paint in the plate. And what you want to do is you want to get it good and saturated. Like this. Get it good. Like that. But you're going to offload it onto a paper towel. To where there's not much left. You want to offload most of it into your paper towel so that it's kind of like a dry brush almost.
This part will.
Okay, so I'm going to start over here and I'm just going to start pouncing. You don't want to swirl. If you swirl, I'm gonna look at it. Yes, it's dark. It's plenty dark. All I need to do is connect right here and right here. You're seeing so it that in real life here, and no bleeding. Absolutely no bleeding. It looks fabulous. I'm just gonna go here and connect to this bee, just like that. There we go. And she's done.
Now,
and so this is what we got so far, and I think it's looking super, super, super duper. What do you guys think? Give me some hearts if you're loving that.
I'm just gonna let this dry on its own here, y'all.
And I'm gonna add some more flowers. All right. Okay, so we can put some of these little flowers just right here. Cute. Just kind of haphazard. All over the piece. I want to put flowers because it says bloom. All right, I'm gonna put that one down there. Yeah, because that'll connect it. And then we're gonna put this one. I'm just gonna cover this whole area down here by the bottom of the cow. Put on. Kind of liking this one for this part here. It's got a stem. And it can come up like that. So that's kind of pretty.
Y'all, look at this. Isn't that stunning already? It doesn't even have any bling on it yet, but it will.
So much. Now that we're done with the stenciling and all of that, what I would like to do, before I put the Totally Dazzled or any of the other things on, I would like to just take a little bit of this. Take a baby wipe. I'll show you how you do this. Simple, simple, simple. Fold it in half and in half again. Like this, okay? And take this Fusion. Now, you don't have to use this. You can spray it. You can Mod Podge it, whatever you want. But this is a wipe on clear tough coat. And it's made for Fusion Mineral Paints products, which I have on here. And it's going to go right over the stencil, that stencil transfer. And all you do is get a little bit on your baby wipe, like this. And then blot it together, like this. So you kind of get it distributed all over, right? And this is what I'm going to do. I'm just going to go wipe. And what it's going to do is it's going to bring all these colors out. It's going to be beautiful. It's going to be so pretty. And you just wipe it on. That's it. It's as simple as that. But, yeah. Okay, and then that's it. That is it. Isn't that cool? It's a nice little finish you got on there. So now what I want to do, now I wanted to make these little ribbon roses. And it only takes a few minutes. I just take strips of fabric. And this is curtain lining, drapery lining fabric. After I tear my strip, I just start twisting it like this. Because this is going to be the middle of your flower. Okay. And you just add, I'm going to put this on low temp glue. I'm just going to put a little dab of glue. I say little dab, but this thing. I'm going to put my little finger protector on, but I use this. I love the color of it. It's an ecru color, and I just love the color of it. And what I do is I start twisting it into a little rosette. I just start making it coiled, okay, like this. And once you get the coil going, then your ribbon rose goes into a different direction. Once you get the coil, the center going, you know, you twist it, and then once you get the center going, you twist it and turn. And then you add a little dab of glue, okay? Just like that. And then you take your working end, put it to your right, twist it and turn it like that. And you're gonna twist it and turn it and add glue as you go. Now, you can make your ribbon roses as big as you want. These are gonna be tiny because it's a little head on here, just not that big, okay? And then in the end, what you do is, let me get my good scissor here, just clip it off. And tuck it up under and glue it right here. Pretty simple. Okay, and we're gonna start it by putting it right here in the middle of her head. Just like that. Okay. Now what I'm thinking, I'd like to do a trio of them, but what I'm thinking is I'd like to add some of the Totally Dazzled in the mix of it, you know what I mean? Like kind of, so let's do a couple more of these little flowers. I'm gonna start by twisting. Okay, we're gonna put this one right over here and squeeze it in on this side. This one almost got too big. What I'm going to do with the Totally Dazzled now is I'm going to take, how cute is that? She's so cute. I love her little rosettes. I'm going to add some of the Totally Dazzled here and there in between and around this like that. I think it's going to be really cool. Like, I'll show you. Puddle some of this up in there. Might have to move this. Move this. No pun intended here. But we're just going to fit a few pieces of the black and white, and it's going to become part of this whole thing. They're just small, but all together they make a statement.
As well, look at that. Isn't that cute? All of her little black and white pieces inside the little ribbon roses. How cute is that, right? And then what I want to do is I want to put that little butterfly. I'm thinking will be really cute. But I think this would be really pretty. I'm going to use the B7000 to attach the butterfly in addition to the hot glue. It's a little heavier. This is a little heavier piece. I'm going to put it right on top of this peony. It's just coming right up. How pretty.
Go with that one. I'm going to go with this little tiny pearl bow tie one. It lays nice and flat on there. Like she's just all gussied up.
All right.
And I'm going to put, she is cute. She's blooming, all right. And I'm going to put, I'm thinking, hold on, where do I want to put this big old, I know where I'm going to put it. I'm going to put it way up here where it says bloom in that corner. It needs something. I see where we're touching. My goodness gracious.
All right.
Okay, guys, I'm going to hold this up, and I'm hoping nothing falls off of it. I hope it's all attached. I think. Thank you so much, you guys. I appreciate all your sweet comments and all your love and your hearts and all of that. Thank you.
Totally Dazzled sells sparkling rhinestone wedding supplies. Check us out at totallydazzled.com. But before you do, click up here and download our free printable sparkle quotes. Or click down here and watch one of our other awesome tutorials.